Yeah. So let's just say on three. Let's just say believe in yourself. All three of us together. One, two, three. Believe in yourself.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Hi, this is Imani, and I am sharing with you the Holistic Harlem Project that we launched as of June 20th, 2018. We seek to improve the awareness of various and ample holistic natural resources that is present and accessible in the Harlem community, and to make this available to the underserved residents, and further educate and inspire people of color on how and why they should take advantage of what is here for us to feed us mind, body, spirit, our economics, and legacy. And for those who are listening to my voice, you can find us on social media and several platforms at Holistic Harlem. So Facebook, it's Holistic Harlem. Instagram, Holistic Harlem. And Eventbrite, Holistic Harlem. HolisticHarlem.eventbrite.com is where you can find us. Hi, my name is Imani, also known as the Wealth Empress, and you're watching an episode of Believe in Yourself.
Hello everybody, this is Claudette for Believe in Yourself video, and guess where I am today? I'm in Harlem, baby. I am at West 105 West 125th Street in Harlem. You can't miss it, close to Lenox Avenue. What brings me out today? A pop-up shop. I came out here and met this wonderful lady by the name of Imani, and I came out here to show her love and to show all the vendors love, because this is what we do. We have to support our own people. Listen, I just got here. I want to walk around and meet all the vendors because I want to have conversations with everybody. I want to talk to them to really kind of find out what they do and how instrumental they are with what they do. These are people that have been in the community for a while and doing great things, because it's not only a pop-up shop, people. They're more than that. So stick around. Don't grab a snack. Just stick around and wait for me to come back. We're going to walk around, meet some of the vendors, and I will be back after this commercial break. But again, you know how you can find me. Several ways. You can find me on Saturdays at the Polo Ground. Every Saturday from 10 a.m. to 12 a.m. You can also find me at 12 p.m. You can also find me on my page, Believe in Yourself Video with Claudette St. Rose, on Facebook, or you can find me also on my email, cvsgea@yahoo.com. But again, if you can't find me, it's because you're not looking hard enough. But enough about me. Let me just walk around and meet the vendors, and I'll be back. Stay close. Beautiful ladies visiting New York. Is this your first time?
It's my first time.
Yeah.
Beverly Wanza.
What is your name? Where are you guys? Where did you travel for?
I came from Arlington, Texas.
Arlington, Texas. And you, sister?
I'm from Auburn, California. It's not my first time.
Okay.
I am a first timer, and I'm from Arlington, Texas,
and
as well.
Your name?
Anita.
Anita. And yes. Did I get your name?
Katrina.
Katrina. And you?
Hi, I'm Robin. This is my first time, and I'm from New Orleans.
And what do you think about Harlem?
I love it.
I'm glad.
Hi, Charlotte Bertrand, first time, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
All right, so we have so many different places here. Isn't that great that we have a sisterhood here? They're from all different places, and they're hanging out. See, this is what women do. You can all hang out without arguing and fighting and have a good time. Isn't that true?
That's true.
So you want to give a shout out to anybody before you go, really quick?
We want to give a shout out to the Sarahs of DST.
All right.
What would you, what would, do your, do, I know you guys have a chance. What is it you do? Do it.
Oh, yes.
All right, well, then let's say believe in yourself then. Can you do that? I am applauded for believe in yourself. So on three, can we all say that? Yeah. One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
Thank you, ladies. You're all so beautiful. Thank you. Harlem Community Newspaper? What do they have to say? Harlem Community, I'm from Brooklyn. What news do they have in this that it's really interesting? A black man did what? A black man did this. Are they talking about Martin Luther King? You know, this is Martin Luther King weekend.
Martin Luther King weekend.
It's a big,
sure.
It's a big to do.
It's a big.
And we're here in Harlem today. Anyway, hello everybody. I am standing with
Nick Ogoto.
How are you, Mr. Ogoto?
I'm very well. Thanks for coming on a snowy day.
Thank you for allowing us to come and really partake with you and your vendors. It's a great spot. It's a nice pop-up shop, and there is a little bit of everything in here.
Yeah, so you have to understand the history of this market.
Come on in, sir.
Yeah, you love to understand the history of the market to understand the setup we have inside here. Most of these people who are vending inside here used to be store owners a few years ago. We're talking about 10, 15, or 30 years ago. But because of gentrification in the community, they lost their stores.
Gentrification.
Then they lost their stores. Some of them became street vendors. Then now we've just got an indoor market for them. But it's a pathway back to where they were already 30 years ago. That means we went back. Now we are beating our way back to where we were before.
Back to the beginning. So what made you come up with the idea of finding a space where you can accommodate people who have been, you know, are obviously like-minded people who are in the business of selling to the community and want to stay really in the community and for people to continue to, you know, to know who they are and really, you know, expose their gifts and talents? Because this is what I feel just in looking here. I mean, there's so many talented vendors in here, and there's so many people who are really giving of themselves and their talents. So what made you come up with the idea to really create this space for them?
It's not my idea, and the idea is not original at all.
Okay.
These ideas exist in the community,
okay. But
it just takes confidence and determination. Community organizing together to come up with these solutions.
Okay.
Otherwise, they already have them. But with all that being said, what happened, I came to New York City as a student at Columbia University.
Awesome.
To do my graduate studies. And my focus was on immigrants and refugee studies. But we started an initiative, you know, as part of our degree program,
right. We
have to do a field placement.
Right.
And that field placement put me right in the heart of this community. And that's when I was confronted with all these challenges that people face in the community. So after my graduation, I said, you know what, somebody has to do this. It's not just about getting your degrees and getting your grades. No, we have to go back into the community.
And
invest and also come together to find solutions to some of the challenges we are facing. And one of them was about street vendings, former store owners having all these challenges. They cannot find a space. And there are a lot of empty stores in the community and nobody was allowed in. So we had to organize and come together and see how we can get one of the spaces, and that's how we got this space.
Well, I think this is, again, it's a great spot. It's very centric. For those who are watching, tell us exactly where you're located.
So we're located on 105 West, 125th Street. It's just by the 2 and 3 train. When you're coming from downtown, you just get off at 125th Street. It's the same block. You don't even have to walk 5 minutes and you'll be here. I know you're very familiar with the big names, that is Marshalls and Staples. We are right in between them. So when you come over here, get off the train, you come to Marshalls, before you reach Staples, we are right in the behind the bus stop. You'll find us there.
So if people wanted more information, are you on social media?
Yes, we are on social media. You can find us on Instagram as at Harlem Artisans Market. You can also find us on Facebook as 125th Street Harlem Market.
125th Street Harlem Market?
Yes.
On Facebook?
On Facebook.
And on Instagram. On the gram. Say the name on the gram again.
Instagram is Harlem Artisans Market.
Harlem Artisans Market on Instagram.
Yes. Or Harlem at Harlem Market. One word.
For more information. And you know, if people wanted information about vending, do you still have space for vendors or no?
So vending here in short term, as you understand, one of the barriers to trading here in some of these properties here is the issue of putting down deposit. So we said if we put a regulation that people have to pay deposit here, then that means we are not breaking down barriers. So you can just come in and pay for the month. That means each and every person has got just a 1 month contract. So we keep changing. If a vendor, some of them are still attending festivals in different places. So if they're attending a festival for 3-4 weeks, they don't have to pay. That means they can just close. Somebody else will get the chance. So all the time we have opportunities right inside the space here.
Well, that's awesome. I just want to thank you and commend you for having a vision. And I know, again, as you said, this is not something new, because as a people, we have to find ways in which to really accommodate our own and help our own. And I'm glad that you had, again, it's not a new idea, but you had the foresight to see that there was a need in the community and to really find a way to help solve the problem. It's not solved, people, because, I mean, gentrification is a hard ball to swallow. It's a hard pill to swallow. And it's not going anywhere. It's happening, and we as a people, we just have to come together as a community and really find ways in which we can help each other to continue to live and hopefully grow.
It's about organizing and sharing information and coming together. You can never solve this this problem as one person. You have to solve this as a community.
As a community.
As a community.
On three, can we say believe in yourself, you and I together? One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
So nice to have met you. It is a pleasure also.
Thank you very much.
On three, let's just say believe in yourself, all three of us together. One, two, three.
Believe in yourself.
Thank you, lady. Oh. There you have it. I came, I saw, I conquered. I met so many humble vendors, so many people who are all about their business, but not only about their business. They're all about staying in their communities and still being visible in ways that, you know, they need to be visible. It's all about coming in and really making this a community of sort where people can continue to exchange ideas and still keep their brand and their products alive. This is what it's all about. It's about doing the things that really makes you happy, that makes you, you know, really in touch with who you are. This is what's happening here in Harlem, people. So I encourage you to come out and visit them here at 105 West 125th Street. Again, it's right here, close to Staples. You can't miss it, right across the street from Whole Foods. So come on in. And again, thank you again. You know how you can reach me. You can reach me at 212-714-7188. Or again, reach me on my email, cvsgea@yahoo.com. Listen, I'm out. It is snowing. I got to get back to Brooklyn. Peace and blessings. Thank you again for supporting me. My kids, love you guys with everything that I am. Until next time, keep watching. Bye.
This is Nikki Sunshine, and you're watching DJ Mario TV. Tune in for the next big thing.